if there was something that they could do that might open up a door to a parallel universe, you don't think they would do it?
The observable universe is huge. It spans for 94 billion light years, but science isn't so sure that we can see everything that's out there. There are those who believe that our universe is just one of a series of an infinite number of universes, all existing in parallel with each other.
A nice example is this beautiful series of pictures by the Dutch artist M.C. Escher. And the one's called Circle Limits, a very famous one with the angels and the devils, and you can see them crowding and crowding and crowding up to the edge. Now, the kind of geometry that these angels and devils inhabit, that's their infinity.
Even Joe Rogan has been talking about the universe and what it could mean for us. But what do the theories say about the universe beyond our own? The idea of universes beyond our own has been a popular topic of science fiction and fantasies for quite a while. The possibility of entire other infinities existing in parallel with our own opens the door for many theories seeking to understand these alternate universes and how they interact with and affect our own universe. In the past number of years, physicists studying in various countries and in the Antarctic have claimed that they have found evidence for parallel universes beyond our own. Before we look at what they found, let's look at what the various theories that predict alternate universes say. The many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics claims that every outcome that possibly can happen does happen. An infinite number of parallel universes are born to play out the countless number of possibilities that occur each day. Another theory regarding multiverses postulates that while the Big Bang was the beginning of the observable universe 13.8 billion years ago, it was not the beginning of everything. It was just another phase within the life of the larger universe. This theory contends that once the inflation of the universe ends, a Big Bang occurs. But inflation is not perfectly uniform across the universe, and it would not end across the whole universe all at once. This leads to inflation continuing in some places, while Big Bangs happen in others. As time keeps moving forward, more Big Bangs will occur, all disconnect from each other, creating their own observable universe. A team of scientists, including Roger Penrose, who is most well known for his work with Stephen Hawking. Their work resulted in the Penrose-Hawking singularity theorems, which formed the foundation for all research centered around black holes today, and has helped a team of astronomers answer questions about mysterious phenomena they found deep in space. The team, working out of the University of Poland, found evidence for another theory called conformal cyclic cosmology, or CCC, which follows the theory that the universe reiterates itself constantly through a series of Big Bangs. They observed a very specific type of cosmic radiation within different small regions of space. This type of radiation was predicted by Hawking and is what you would expect to find coming from a black hole. The only problem for the team was that there was no evidence of any gravitational forces in these areas which would come with the presence of a black hole. In their theory, Hawking and Penrose had theorized this type of radiation and concluded that it is essentially leftover radiation from another universe and that its presence predates the Big Bang. But what is this energy exactly, and where did it really come from? The team put together a rough timeline of how this radiation came to exist in our universe. After the Big Bang, a universe will be filled with matter, expand, and grow until it gets very old. Eventually, gravity will cause the matter of the universe to condense into black holes until the universe is filled with them. They release radiation as they age and will eventually evaporate and leave the universe as a sort of giant soupy mess of electrons and other particles. The particle soup will eventually collapse on itself, which leads to another Big Bang and gives rise to the next universe. This series of events would continue over and over again in perpetuity. One of the most influential parts of this study is that the team found that there is an issue with the way cosmic inflation is understood. This theory will need to be reviewed and updated as additional studies look at these cosmic anomalies. A few years ago, another team of scientists working at the Antarctic Impulsive Transient Antenna, ANITA, a radio wave sensitive experiment set up to detect radio waves that pass through the Earth or come from space. The team detected a set of radio waves with very peculiar energies coming up from beneath the Antarctic ice. These readings showed that Anita had just experienced a rare event, as the energies were consistent with high-energy neutrinos. But at these energies, these particles should not have been able to pass through the Earth uninhibited and should have been stopped at some point on their journey. And the experiment did not pick up just one of these events. It picked up three. According to the team, there are three possibilities for what they saw. There may have been an astrophysical source for these particles that astronomers simply are not aware of yet. There could have been a flaw in either the detector or the team's interpretation of the data they received from the detector, or something remarkable, exotic, and beyond the standard model occurred. And these particles were a result of the violation CPT, which is a vital component of this theory. And if our universe cannot violate CPT, which all evidence points to it not being able to, the only other explanation is that these particles traveled from a parallel universe where the laws governing CPT are reversed. So could these particles be from another universe? While these particles originating from a parallel universe are within different theories or models, it is still an unlikely conclusion to come to. Another experiment stationed in Antarctica, Ice Cube, did not pick up any of these readings, which they definitely should have, according to all the evidence. The team working at Ice Cube also took a follow-up look at the original data that came out to see if they had another interpretation. They were able to rule out the leading theory that the particles came through the Earth at all, and something is amiss with the experiment. While this experiment may not have been the one to confirm a parallel universe, there is still a large portion of the scientific community behind the various theories, including multiple universes. Is there more hope of finding evidence in the near future? The Hubble Space Telescope has measured some discrepancies between the estimates for the inflation rate of the universe, which is so statistically significant that astronomers know something is wrong with their models and a new interpretation is needed. One theory that explains the discrepancies with the expansion rate includes scaling symmetry, as well as a mirror world that would essentially be a parallel mirror copy of our universe, in which its new particles are all copies of known particles from our universe. While this theory first originated in the 1990s, it is just now getting its recognition as a possible solution to this problem. Luckily, NASA is on the case, and they have already planned a new telescope, the Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope, that will explore the value of this inflation discrepancy across cosmic time and collect more data, which will hopefully shed more light that will reveal what is behind the problems with the current models. Thanks for watching. How do you feel about the possibility of a universe beyond our own? Is there anything you hope comes out of this? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on Matter.